Good morning. My name is Steve Zwinger, and I work at the NDSU Carrington Research Extension Center. We are in one of the organic fields at the center, and this field here has been certified organic since 2006. And with me is the left and right-hand man of the organic project, Steve Shalbert. We call ourselves Steve Squared. Say hi, Steve.
Hi, folks.
The work that is done out here cannot be done without Steve, and so I thank him very much. Well, with that, I'm here today to talk about the Northern Plains Sustainable Ag Society's Farm Breeding Club and determinate buckwheat. So this is a project, we work very closely with Northern Plains and farmers working on developing varieties and evaluating seeds for organic farming systems. And with that, we are working on a project that started in 2013 that was funded by a SARE project. It was a SARE Farmer Rancher grant with three farmers involved and the Carrington Research Center. The variety we're talking about here is called Dovakia buckwheat. This seed came from the Ukraine. In 2013, members of the Farm Breeding Club coordination team acquired a very small amount of this seed. We wrote a grant, Farmer Rancher grant, to work on this project. The project was met with much failure, meaning cropping conditions, hail, drought, grasshoppers. And we revisited it the last couple years. Today, what we're standing from is a small seed increase. This project was funded by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, so thank you very much for that. This is a small backup increase. There's a 2-acre increase on Owen Trangsrud Farms, who is a member of the Farm Breeding Club down in Enderlin. And so what happened is, in 2013-14, we were working with this project. The first year in 2013, there was about 1,000 grams of seed sown on Ann Ongsted's farm, the project leader, down in Robinson. From 1,000 grams, we turned it into 55 pounds of seed. That seed was then seeded on Rick Mittleiter's farm the next year, but it was met with adverse conditions, such as a very, very bad rainstorm that washed it out, and we did not get any production. There was only a small amount of seed left, and last year it was planted. About 2 pounds was planted on this field, a little less than 2 pounds, and we turned it into 99.6 pounds of seed. That led to this increase as a backup and the seed that was seeded on Owen Trangsrud Farm. During those years, we were able to get evaluation 1 year on 2014 in the research plots. Those research plots showed us, you know, so we don't have conclusive data on this variety to see if it's adapted for farmers. But, and again, I should say, if we don't understand what determinate means compared to indeterminate, buckwheat is an indeterminate crop, meaning it will flower, it will continue flowering until it either freezes or dies or is swathed. So this is a determinate variety, meaning it will flower, quit flowering, and then we'll harvest it. So that can be advantageous and it can be a tool for us, although the resiliency of indeterminate is also a tool. So that's what we're here about, is to determine that. So what did we find in 2014 when we were able to put it under replicated plots? We found that this variety will flower slightly earlier than our other varieties, 3 to 4 days earlier. And again, if we look at this, we can see it's flowering. This increase, well, it was planted May 26th. Today is June 26th. That's 30 days. So it's flowering in 30 days. That's the same thing our data showed us. Buckwheat will, indeterminate varieties, will flower generally from anywhere from 32 to 38 days, depending upon the weather conditions. This one, again, as I mentioned, will flower about 3 days earlier. But the beauty of it is, it will flower and then quit flowering. That also can be a problem, because if the conditions aren't right during that time period of flowering, we won't have the resiliency that buckwheat has. We found that it will flower early, and again, it's pointed out. And as I showed you, this spot looks a little bit bad here, because why? The deer like to come through and eat it. So if you see where it's variable here, they've chewed down and ate it. If we get back here, they didn't. And again, we can see how it's flowering very uniformly. And so this has been flowering for 1 to 2 days already. And so what did we find also? We found that it's a little bit shorter than the other varieties, 3 to 4 inches. And its test weight was about average. Its kernel weight was a little bit better, meaning the amount of seeds per pound or the size of those seeds, and its yield was about average. So, you know, again, we do have it in our variety trial this year to evaluate that, and we're getting, we have a seed backup at Owens Farm, and hopefully that seed will then become available if we have a successful harvest from 2 acres. There will be adequate seed then to get on many more farms. So basically, we are doing, this group of farmers is on-farm research. We really believe in that, and so we believe in farmers working with the land grant, helping them. That was the original mission when the land grant was started off, and that's what we're trying to do with the Farm Breeder Club. And so again, that's the Northern Plains Sustainable Ag Society's Farm Breeder Club, who this tour is a part of. And again, thank you OCIA for funding this project and helping us develop organic seed. Thank you.